Welcome, welcome to the Ice Turner Experience. This is an experience quite like no other. Because I break down the game in kaleidoscope form to adjust the pigment of your lens on how you see yourself and things. Now, this is something that, you know, if you listen to intently, continually, you will notice the transformation take place. Because this isn't that weirdo rap that you're used to. This is something that you have to listen to. You have to re-listen to, you have to replay it in your mind, you have to replay it again afterwards to, you know, to have it fully activated in you. Because this is the spirit of the game, it's a living organism. It'll breathe and permeate through you. You know, this isn't really armchair rhetoric. This isn't textbook theories. This is something that was experienced on the concrete and then translated. Ice Turner. You can't just nod your head to this beat. You really gotta empty your mind. Sit back, relax, and take this in. Now, today's message is gonna be part two of Esoteric Seduction. Now, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I encourage you to do so. Also, look at previous videos to get a full understanding of what this experience is and for a much deeper and greater level of knowledge and growth exponentially. I would encourage you to subscribe to the Patreon. The name is the same. The game is much deeper. Most people say that, but I just let the people talk. they are more confident in. Because they're on a constant drive for accomplishment and external approval. Now, this is the plight of most males because they almost always choose to pine after something they don't already have. And they constantly compare to, compete with, and complain against other men, making envy their most prevalent emotion that they are driven by. Now, on one hand, you have the introverted male who attempts to downplay or belittle their sexual expectation and appetite, while the extroverted one, on the other hand, overly projects and exaggerates their desirability with a larger-than-life image. They try to assert themselves with a larger, or unrealistic concept of themselves that is in the contrary of what is actually taking place in their life and within their conversation. But there are the few and the fortunate that are blessed with enormous charm and sexual charisma, on the other hand, that don't flaunt it with stuff, with sizzle, but just have substance and sustenance. Now, even if they don't have the charismatic personality and are not necessarily seductive, but somehow, everywhere they go, people can't help to fall under their spell. Because people find their masculine aura very captivating. Even a woman in her feminine aura, in her feminine essence. See, men with that level of magnetism have the tendency to attract female attention, like bees to honey, or more important, moth to light. Because women look to us to fulfill that heart's desire. Remember what I said before, a woman wears her heart on her pussy. That means she evaluates conversations and movement, body language with a sexual component to it. Yes, women are more sexual than you. Women think about sex twice as much as you. Guys with high levels of sexual magnetism appear to look ageless. See, the thing is, our skin color, our race, our economic condition have no power, or I would say, no influence over our power. Because we, naturally command affection, attention, respect without even asking for it. You know, I can't remember the last time I actually had to pay for a meal or even pay for a bill. Yeah. See, that is the difference. That is the difference. See, the more centered you are, the more potent your game is, right? Why do I keep saying that? Why haven't you not grasped that yet? Same reason why I keep saying that. Be true to thyself. Because when you can be true to thyself as far as seeing your deficiencies and infirmities and dealing with those and managing those, the better you are at dealing with your own insecurities or insecurity with a level of prowess, the more covered you are in your situation, right? See, we all have flaws. It's just, what are you, how are you dealing with your flaws? What are you covering them with? Are you covering them with fig leaves? Overly compensating yourself? Camouflaging yourself with other people that are probably cooler than you, smarter than you, better looking than you, and etc.? Or are you just dealing with those things and standing on your own and listening to good content that's going to actually help you grow? See, toy food is for little children. They like to talk to clowns. Okay? Now, do you want McDonald's or do you want Chop House? Do you want power? Or do you want popcorn, soda, and candy? Now, are you really about the game or are you about playing games? Are you a man or are you really a hoe posing as one? See, those decisions are both yours. So you need to decide or make the decision today on who you want to be. Chitch.